Thank you for watching videos by Jeff Sibelius and LandAndAirPhotos.com. Last year, Autel announced the upcoming release of two separate pairs of new consumer-level drones. These drones are now shipping, so I wanted to tell you what they offer. The first pair is the Evo Nano series, which includes the Nano and the Nano Plus. One thing I really like about all the new Autel drones is that they're sold in different colors. The Nano is available in Arctic White, Deep Space Gray, Blazing Red, or the classic Autel Orange. Now, I'm not thrilled with white or gray drones, but Autel gives you the choice, and the red and orange versions are easily visible in the sky. The Nano weighs less than 250 grams, so it's not subject to the registration rules and other regulatory requirements in various countries. It sports a 1/2-inch CMOS sensor, slightly bigger than the Mavic Mini 2's 1/2.3-inch sensor, with a 12-megapixel camera that can record 4K 30 frames per second video. The camera is mounted on a 3-axis mechanical gimbal. The Nano uses Autel's Skylink image transmission system, which is advertised to have a transmission range of about 6.2 miles. The Nano is supposed to have Dynamic Track 2.1 that can follow people, animals, or vehicles. It's also supposed to have the following automatic shooting modes: Skyrocket/Missile, Float/Adrift, Orbit/Satellite, and Helicopter/Hurricane/Whiplash/Whirlwind. I say supposed to have because these features are not currently enabled. They will be added in a future firmware update. Releasing an incomplete drone didn't make people happy with the Mavic 3, and I don't imagine Nano buyers will be too happy about this either. The Evo Nano is advertised to fly for 28 minutes on one battery. The Evo Nano Plus delivers all the features of the Nano with some significant enhancements. The Nano Plus has a 1/1.28-inch CMOS sensor and shoots 50-megapixel photos. The Nano Plus employs a new sensor that uses an RYYB color filter array design and a fixed aperture of f1.9, which is supposed to improve the camera's performance in low-light conditions. The Nano Plus is the only sub-250-gram drone that I'm aware of that includes obstacle avoidance to the front, behind, and below. The second pair of new drones from Autel is the Evo Lite series. The series consists of the Lite and the Lite Plus. The Lite features a 50-megapixel camera equipped with a 1/1.28-inch CMOS sensor. The camera uses the new RYYB color filter array design, which absorbs 40% more light than traditional RGGB arrays, to improve color rendition, particularly in low-light situations. The Evo Lite is the first drone in the world to introduce a 4-axis gimbal design, allowing you to shoot in portrait as well as in landscape orientation. The Lite uses Autel's Skylink image transmission system, which is promoted to offer a transmission range of 7.4 miles. Not that anyone should ever use that. Like the Nano, the Lite is supposed to offer Dynamic Track 2.1 and have the same automatic shooting modes. Again, these features are not currently enabled in the Lite. They will be added in a future firmware update. The Lite battery is advertised to last 40 minutes. The Lite offers three-way obstacle sensing and is available in three different colors: Arctic White, Deep Space Gray, and Autel Orange. There's no blazing red for the Evo Lites, and that's too bad. That color looks really cool on a drone. Finally, the top of Autel's new drone lineup is the Lite Plus. The Plus version has all the features of the Lite with the following differences. The Lite Plus offers a 1-inch CMOS sensor with an adjustable aperture from f2.8 to f11. It shoots up to 6K video at 30 frames per second and 20-megapixel stills. Built into the system is Autel's intelligent moonlight algorithm, which allows the Lite Plus to get better color and detail with reduced noise, even while shooting at night. It also has a defog mode, which is essentially a setting that enhances the contrast and vibrance to offset the effects of a foggy or cloudy environment. Unlike the Lite Plus does not rotate the sensor to shoot portrait photos. Portrait orientation is accomplished by digitally cropping the image. Those are the stats about the new Autel drones. So, what do I think about them? Well, let's talk about the positives. First, I'm excited to see a non-DJI drone competing directly against the Mini 2, Air 2S, and even the Mavic 3. I'm not at all happy with the Mavic 3 for reasons I'll discuss in a future video. When that's published, you'll see it linked in the upper right corner now. But I'm not pleased with the Mavic 3 for several reasons, which makes a new series of drones from another manufacturer very exciting. Autel has a long track record of great customer service, which is another reason to like these drones. I've heard about people having some problems getting support in the last couple months, but from what I understand, Autel's tech support team has been hit pretty hard by the pandemic. So hopefully they'll be back to their stellar customer support very soon. I love having the choice on colors, which allows drone operators the ability to choose as to whether or not they'll be safe. I'm also anxious to see what kind of flight times you really get from these drones. My Evo 2 Pro is advertised to fly for 40 minutes on one battery. I don't get 40 minutes from a flight, but the flight times are crazy long, and I love that. And the features and advertised capabilities for these drones make them very, very interesting. On the downside, Autel released these drones before they were fully completed, so several popular features won't be available until firmware updates are released. Now, I hate that they did this, but it has already taken them a long time to get these drones out since they were first announced, so I think I understand why they did it. Still, all the drone companies need to stop treating their first round of customers as beta testers. None of the new Evos will offer waypoints. I'm not sure why the manufacturers have abandoned this feature. You don't get it on the Air 2S or the Mavic 3, and you don't get it on any of these new Evos. If you want to fly waypoints, you'll have to go with one of the Evo 2 drones. As is usually the case, the Autel drones are more expensive than their DJI counterparts. Now, these new drones also provide features you don't get from the DJI counterparts, like obstacle avoidance on the Nano Plus, and they don't have DJI's geofencing. So, you'll have to decide whether it's worth it or not to pay a premium to go with something other than DJI. Unfortunately, the new Evos are now even more expensive than they were just a couple weeks ago. How much more? Each drone went up in price anywhere from $150 to $200. Ouch! What happened? Well, you probably won't be shocked to learn that this price jump is the result of the U.S. government, which tinkered with tariff categorizations on Chinese products. They recategorized the Evos, and the associated tariffs jumped by more than 300%. Autel has released a statement on this situation. I put a link to that statement in the description below. That said, the new prices make the Nano and Lite drones much more expensive than their DJI counterparts. These prices will probably make the drones difficult to justify for many owners. Ultimately, the success of the new Autel drones will come down to the quality of video they deliver. If their video is better than what you get from the DJIs, many people will pay the premium for them, especially if they understand that the gouging is coming from our government and not from Autel. I do have hope for the Evos. I've watched a lot of sample footage over the past several weeks, and I've been very impressed by the video samples from the Nano and the Lite drones. So impressed that I purchased an Evo Lite Plus. Fortunately, I got it just before the new prices kicked in. So I will soon be putting the Lite Plus through the rigorous testing that is part and parcel of an official non-fanboy review. I can't wait to put the Lite Plus up against the Air 2S. This will be an epic comparison. I have no sense of which drone I'd like better, and that will make this testing all the more fun. If you've been shopping, you know these drones can be hard to find from American-based retailers. Autel simply can't produce them fast enough for resellers to keep them in stock. Given what's going on with Russia right now, and how that could influence circumstances with China, it's very possible that we could see more tariffs in the coming months, or worse, we could see the U.S. cut off importation of products like drones. All that's to say, if you want to buy one of these drones and you can find it in stock somewhere reputable, avoid the Chinese websites selling Evos right now, you should probably put your order in now. In the description, you'll find links to several different reputable sources for Autel drones. Click them to check the current status of inventory at each location. Lots of cool reviews and tutorials coming soon on different drones, so be sure to hit the Cartoon Jeff icon and subscribe. I put links on screen to some recent episodes, so be sure to check those out. And your likes and comments do help my channel succeed, so be sure to sound off before you go. Thanks for watching.